Fred Andrews here from the Convention and Visitors Bureau. GoRockford.com. Stroll on state, not wet.
Oh, I don't. That was a stroll miracle, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
Because we were watching the forecast, of course, many days before the event, and it said rain, rain, rain. And then what happens? It rains the day before and dumps snow the next day.
But that
Nothing.
Day, clear it out. We've got a big party going on here. We need to keep it nice.
That's right.
And unfortunately, we had house guests and time didn't line up. We didn't get a chance to make it this year.
It was great.
Spectacular as always. I've heard nothing but good reviews.
I always say this. I even wrote a blog about it just because it meant so much to me. Every year just keeps getting better and better.
Yeah.
And right when I think I can't love it more, I do the next year. So no pressure, guys. No pressure.
Just keep it on that kind of roll. Well, you've done it for six straight years. Every year has seen improvements, growth in attendance.
Yes. And so we are tallying up all the different attendance numbers that we normally do each year. And we're hoping to get those attendance numbers out soon. But in the meantime, we're just enjoying the fact that the event was such a blast. Everyone had such a good time. I was walking around. There were so many happy faces. All the little kids were just enjoying their time. We were at the parade, and the folks were throwing candy out to the kids, and just the giggles and grabbing the candy and watching the big balloons. It was just, it was like such a cool experience. It was like a mini Macy's Day Parade in Rockford.
That's outstanding.
Really
I never asked you this question, and I'm curious about it. The Stroll on State concept, borrowed? Heard about it being done elsewhere, thought we could pull this kind of thing off here. Was it, is it unique? Is it something you guys were sitting in the conference room at work and went, you know, I've got an idea.
You know, it started off from an idea of the fact that somebody said, what, you know, other communities have Christmas tree lightings and celebrations. There's definitely some even in our community.
Right.
But we don't really have a city community-wide downtown celebration. And so that was the question that was posed, and somebody said, you know what? That's right. We don't. We never really had considered that or thought of that. Why don't we do that? So it was just a tiny idea that really, you know, 6 years later, look what it's turned into. So
you look around to see what other communities around the nation were doing and maybe pull an idea or two idea.
You know, you always, whatever works for your community is best, but it doesn't hurt to get some ideas from other areas too. So yeah, definitely a little bit of both, but all in all, again, you know, the Rockford community, we're so unique. Our downtown is so great. We have the river, which is so amazing, and the beautiful bridge. So, you know, we've got a lot of great space to work with, and that makes this event so cool because we can use the west side and the east side of the river for all the different attractions. We have great local businesses right in the River District where we can work with indoor vendors and spaces along with outdoor. So it just makes sense. It's like, why haven't we been doing this for so long?
Well, I don't think you're going to get out from under doing it for a very long time either.
At
the rate of progression this has made, people love this event and look forward to it.
I love when the mayor says, he has two little ones, and he says his kids will never not know a Rockford without Stroll on State and a Christmas celebration. And I always love when he says that.
That's cool.
It's so cool. When I was younger, I just didn't have an event like this in my community, but now we do. So it's really neat.
And kudos to everybody down at the Rockford Area Convention and Visitors Bureau. Your boss down there, John Groh, and all of the rest of you. You work so hard. You guys are so creative. You come up with great ideas and fun ways of executing them. Home run once again.
On behalf of the team, thank you so much.
Yeah, when there's a cash envelope, that won't be going to the team. She's going to keep that herself. But the rest, you know, the kudos get passed right along.
I love it.
What are we doing this weekend?
Well, the holidays are approaching, of course, so they're continuing this weekend as well. We have the 34th annual Rockton Christmas Walk going on in downtown Rockford. It's always a hit, always so much fun. Friday through Sunday, so times will vary. They have a great schedule of activities and events happening all weekend long. So you're going to want to check out their website. GoRockford.com has information as well. But it is a tradition in their community. The local businesses will be open. I hear Dairy House is opening back up just for this weekend.
Nice.
Very, very fun. They have a pancake breakfast with Santa tomorrow. You're going to be able to enjoy the annual parade. They're going to do their Christmas tree lighting. I'm sure Santa will be there.
Sure
and
will.
So many more fun things going on. So if you can head on over to Rockton, it's not, you know, just our neighbors here in Rockford.
I'm telling you, and Rockton has so many things throughout the course of the year
they
that should
do.
Bring you up because they do a lot of cool events, a lot of cool festivals. And this is one that I thoroughly enjoy.
Oh, I agree. So should be a great time. And then also on Saturday, this is a big one for me because I don't know if you're like me, but my holiday shopping hasn't begun yet. So
Yeah, there's that.
I know.
I am with you. Mine hasn't either.
So a local holiday market is the event for us then. It's on Saturday. It's 10 to 4. It's at Rockford University in the Burpee Center. I always love the Winnebago Buy Local group does a phenomenal job partnering together. So it's all the different businesses throughout the Rockford area, Winnebago County. So 30 of the different local businesses are partnering, and they're going to be under one roof. They're going to be selling many different handmade goods and items. So you're going to want to go to this event because this is where you're going to get those original, unique gifts. You're not going to be able to find just anywhere. And the first 200 families will receive a reusable shopping bag so that you can carry your purchases along with you.
Very cool.
Makes it super convenient.
And for those who bristle a little bit at an event where you go, okay, we want you to come in and buy all these really cool things, but we need you to pay us to get inside first. You'll love this because it's free.
You got it.
Free admission to get in there and shop to your heart's content.
There you go. Win-win.
Win-win.
And another one of my favorite events of all time, the Nutcracker, is happening at the Coronado Performing Arts Center. And it is a bonus because you get the Rockford Dance Company and the Rockford Symphony Orchestra together in one amazing ballet performance.
Killer.
I know. So this is going to be so much fun. Saturday and Sunday. Now there's a 7:30 p.m. Showing on Saturday and then a 3 p.m. showing on Sunday. And you're going to be at the Coronado Performing Arts Center. So it's...
I can't think of a better place to see it.
Wherever you look, there's going to be beauty.
Yeah, absolutely. On the stage, all around you, up
everywhere.
Above you, you name it, you win there.
So, and this is always a tradition. I love the Nutcracker. It just, and it comes to life on that stage, and it's just so beautiful. So
that's the venue to see it.
You got it. So if you can make it out, I always recommend when you're downtown, grab some dinner beforehand if you're going on Saturday, or some lunch beforehand on Sunday.
Nice idea.
And last but not least, the 9th annual Tour de Frost. This is a fun event put on. Vitamin Shop is where the starting point is and the end point is. And then you are going to be 20 miles of bike riding on Saturday. What do you think about that?
Well, I think that for the people who are into that sort of thing, I wish them all the luck in the world. I will be on a couch or maybe perhaps under a blanket wishing them all the best in their exploits.
I know. There are definitely some athletic, motivated people that... Look at this as a really big challenge.
Sure.
And, you know, kudos. Kudos to you folks.
For doing it so we don't have to.
There you go. So it should be really fun, though, if you are interested in biking and you like this sort of thing. I've followed them around before in my car to take some photos.
That would be the way to do it, sure.
And I give them a lot of credit. So your stops will be the Olympic Tavern, Rockford Bicycle Company. But this is the cool incentive. At the very end, they're going to throw a pizza party at Oscar's Pub and Grill. So there's the incentive.
I might ride a bike for the 20 miles for pizza. Sure, okay. You've talked me into it.
There you go. So Saturday registration between 9 and 9:45. The ride's at 10 a.m. So if you want to sign up, they will, you know, you can walk right up and do it. So if you're not sure if you're interested, if you don't know if, you know, you can make it yet, you can still go the day of.
Well, look at it this way. How good are you going to feel about yourself getting that done?
Right?
Yeah.
And you know, it's just like those 5K runs and walks and the marathons and all that. Like, you check it off your bucket list and say,
yeah,
I did that.
I made it through that. I came out the other side. I'll be all right.
It makes you stronger.
You know, let's say if it doesn't kill you. Sure, let's go with that.
There you go.
Everything you mentioned on the website?
Yep, gorockford.com.
Have a fantastic weekend.
You
Thanks
too.
For the info.